Today at the House of Hacks, we're gonna go from this to this. Oh yeah. Hi makers, builders, and do-it-yourselfers, Harley here. The general illumination in my shop is all fluorescent lights. And for quite some time now, I've been wanting to upgrade them to LEDs. Recently, I've had two bulbs that were kind of on the way of going out, and today they just didn't come on at all. So I went down to the home store and decided to bite the bullet and convert a couple of my fixtures to the fixtures, total of four bulbs, over from fluorescent to LED. In all my investigation, I've found that there are kind of three principal ways of doing this conversion. The first is very quick, very easy, and expensive. The second is less expensive and also a little bit more work. And the third way is the most amount of work, but also the least expensive. So today, because of time pressure, I decided to go on these with the first option of the most expensive, but the fastest and easiest to do. For cost comparison, these bulbs are $60 a piece, and I have four bulbs to replace. So that means a total cost on this conversion today was $240. Now, to put it in perspective, I think I only paid $200 for the whole fixtures originally, including fluorescent tubes. So it is quite a bit more expensive, but now I have LED lighting with all the benefits thereof. So today I want to look at what it takes to install them and what the difference is in the light output. So let's get to it. So these come in 4 foot long packages. There's two tubes that snap together to make an 8 foot section. They're made by Fate Electric. I don't know how you really pronounce that. They replace both T8 and T12 bulbs. And the advantage of these is they work off the ballast voltages. So all you have to do is take out the old bulb and replace it with the new one after you put everything together and unpackage it. It says it's rated for up to 50,000 hours of life. We'll see how that actually works itself out. Uses 44 watts and has a color temperature of 4100 Kelvin. So it's kind of in the middle of the color temperature range. Here we have one set of ends as packed. A cap is over one piece for shipping to cover the open middle where the two pieces will be joined together. It can be removed and discarded. And the other end contains the power pin that will connect to the light fixture. Here's the other set of ends. One end has a clear plastic piece over it that contains a magnet. This will stabilize the center of the light. Remove it for now and set it aside. This is the other pin that will connect to the light fixture. The other piece has a connector with two spring-loaded pins. Pull this out until the pin locks into place. Now slide the clear plastic support over the end without the connector, but don't cover the small hole for the locking pin. Slide the two pieces together until the pin locks into place. Finally, slide the plastic piece over the joint to help support the connection. We can see half the tube is aluminum extrusion to provide support and heat dissipation. The other half has a curved frosted diffuser. Installation is just like a normal fluorescent tube. Once both ends are in place, push the middle up so the magnet sticks to the fixture for support. And that's really all there is to it. You snap the two pieces together, take out the old bulbs, put in the new bulbs. Short, sweet, simple. Really like it. It seems to work out really well. Now let's go take a look at what the actual light output is.
The measurement of tubes is on the left and the LEDs on the right. There is one EV difference between the two. In photographic terms, this is one stop, or twice the amount of light out of the LEDs.
So you can see the light output from these is quite a bit more. It'll be nice having consistent color temperature across all my bulbs too. So working in the shop should be much more pleasant for me. If this is your first time here, welcome. We're glad you're here. All my videos have to do with maker-related types of topics, woodworking, metalworking, shop projects in general, kind of like this. If that kind of thing sounds interesting to you, go ahead and subscribe. We'd love to see you in the next video. Until next time, go make something. It doesn't have to be perfect, just have fun.